Hey, good morning. It's great to see you today. It's Tuesday, the 10th of October. And thank you for those who prayed yesterday for Tom's funeral, that it would go well. It did. The church was packed, which was amazing to see, and to see how well loved and supported he was. So, and God really helped me and Karen and the band. So thank you very much for praying. I really do appreciate that. These are big things. So anyway, thank you for that. So today I'm going to be doing this devotion. I'm going to be hopefully travelling down to Kent to see my parents on the train. If the train's running, there's a bit of a problem with the viaduct at Cramlington. So, but I think my train is running. So please pray I get there on time, safely and everything. So that will go really well. Continuing the devotion today in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. It's titled New Bodies. So when we read this next scripture, we need to remember, when we look at scripture, we need to rethink about a few things. The technical term for it is called hermeneutics. But really what that means, we have to think about who wrote it, when he wrote it, what was the culture, what was going on at the time, what was the writer's original intention from this. And what can we glean? What can we learn? How can we grow? How will God speak to us through this today? So Corinthians is the second book that Paul wrote to the Corinthians. Yes, there was first one was like it was a church. So in Corinth, in Greece, it was full of there was loads of stuff cracking off. There was spiritual gifts left, right, and center. But there's all kinds of, with a thriving, growing church, there's all kinds of stuff that needed to be addressed, and Paul did. And the verse yesterday we looked at was he talked about, this is new bodies, he talked about our goal, whether here or away from this body, is our goal is to please God. It's to please God in everything that we do. And then we say, and we do that by doing the things that he said, which is Jesus said, go into the world and make disciples. Do the things that Jesus said, you know, like to stand up to anointed, to speak, preach good news, to bring freedom to the captives, and so on. Verse 10 says this, and this is the reason why we should. For we must all stand before Christ to be judged. We will each receive whatever we deserve for the good or evil we've done in this earthly body. Now remember, of course, we know everyone will stand before God and they'll be judged what they've done with Jesus. But for us, the Christian, if your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, if you're a Christian, that is already dealt with. But this is talking about something. This is written to this book. It is written to Christians. It is written to the church. So I don't think Paul here is necessarily talking about that judgment, because we're found not guilty. Because when Jesus sees us, he sees we're covered by his blood. We are the blood. We are washed in the blood of Jesus. And so we are found not guilty, not because of our own righteousness, but because of his righteousness, his righteousness. So what is this talking about? Well, we must all stand before Christ to be judged. I didn't think we had to do that. Yes, we'll receive whatever we deserve for the good or the evil we've done in this earthly body. So there is, although we won't be judged for our sins, we'll be judged for what have we done with our lives. And people say, I've served God. And that's one of those things, isn't it? Is whether what we've done. Have we done the things he said? Jesus said, if you love me, you'll obey my commands. Well, have you obeyed his commands? How are you living? Are you living righteously? Or is your faith, is it just an excuse just to carry on living the same way that you've always lived and not to make any change in your life? Just to make excuses for how you are, for what you do, for how you live. Because the Bible says we should be changed, being changed from one degree of glory to another. We should be becoming more like Jesus. That's the first thing. We'll be judged by the fruit in our lives. The fruit in our lives. Because God, this is what Jesus said. God said it right at the beginning. He said, and actually it was probably Jesus, because Jesus spoke and the world came to being. He said, go into the world and be fruitful. In Matthew 28, Jesus said the same thing. He said, go and make disciples, i.e. go and be fruitful. So we'll be judged with the fruit. One fruit we know is the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, and self-control. We will be judged for that. We'll be judged by the other fruit. It might mean, yes, for some people it will be fruit, can be fruit from through salvation, but it can be other, it can be different things. But we will each have to stand before God. Not you, not your pastor for you. We each have to take responsibility for our own lives, for our own lives, for what we have done with them. And we will receive, the Bible says we will receive a crown of life. But some will receive more rewards than others. See the parable of the talents. He had five and he got five more. He had 10. And then the one had three. He got three more. He had six. But one had more than the other. And the one who had, we buried, it was taken away from him. So we'll each receive reward with what we've got, with what God has placed us with. We are to steward that gift, and to make use of him. So this is talking about that. Let's make sure today that we steward what God has given us well, that we use it for his glory, not for our glory. Because if we have it for our glory, we'll get our glory or our reward already here, and we'll miss out on that eternal reward. Let's do whatever we're going to do, let's do it for his glory, his praise, so that his name will be lifted high, so that he would receive all the glory, and the kingdom of God will come to heaven, from heaven to earth. So let's do the best we can with that. Let's make sure that today we submit everything to God and we are fruitful in the right sense. Listen, I hope you have a great day today. Take care. God bless. Think about me on the train going down, and we'll see you tomorrow in Jesus' name. Amen.